Hindu editorial analysis. Today is 30 of January 2021. The first article is regarding the economic survey, which predicts about 11% growth to the next fiscal year. So what the Indian economic survey predicts that there will be a growth of 11% for the next financial year. And also CEA says that it's time to switch to financial, which gets from the cautious stance of a counter cycle. Because of the coronavirus, there is the drastic fall of economy, because most of the things have been stagnant. And the author of or the economic survey, which says that, which also predicts that there will be an increase of 11% for the next financial year, because everything will be normalized due to the health infrastructure have been doing very excellent, and also there is a vaccine which is rolled out and which is boosting the allying services, spur in the consumption and also investment. So India's response to once in a century crisis, and there is should be a lesson of democracy, and also this will be a boost for the next financial year. The recovery story from being one of the fastest contracting economies in the financial year of 2021. The economic survey estimates the India to post one of the rapidest GDP expansions for the year of 2022. So, and there will be a V-shaped recovery and V-shaped growth, as India's GDP is expected to be contracted 7.7% this financial year of 21, and also compared to the last financial year, that is 4.2% growth in the 2020. So this is due to the pandemic, and not only our economy, every other nation's economy has been drastically decreased or declined due to this COVID-19. In absolute terms, the proportionality is small. So India's estimated GDP growth in financial year 2022 is highest among the economies picked by the Indian Monetary Fund, and this is in terms of per capita GDP income. And also there is a health infrastructure which is must be ailed. The COVID-19 has showcased the healthcare and can transform and the many of the economic and social crisis, and also economic survey noted. Due to this, there will be a prediction that there will be the growth of next fiscal year of economy of India. In the first article, which says that the budget blueprint for the difficult times, this article is penned by the three eminent persons. The first person is Manmohan Singh, who is the former prime minister and also economist, and second person is the Chidambaram, and third one is Pravin Chakravarti, who is the senior, also the party member of Congress party. What does he says the article, what exactly the budget should be defined for the next coming year, says these three persons. Let's have a look into this article. Alarming inequality and also failing healthcare and also border tensions loom a large, and also economic situation, there should be full attention to be kept in this scenario, and the budget should be prepared into the consideration of these inequalities and also healthcare sector and tensions. The budget should be framed in such a way that they should curtail all these things and balance the situation of the society. And also budget, the blueprint for different difficult times, there is also an inequality between the haves and have-nots, which is even worsened due to this COVID-19 pandemic. In the situation where we have seen in the earlier past that the one who have means the one who can afford to live without any or so-called the lockdown stages, they are having a very good probability of living, rather than the one who are unable to make up their day without any financial aid. So this is also one of the impact that should be kept in mind while preparing the budget, says the author. There are missed opportunities, that is due to this unplanned and sudden nature of lockdown. There are also missed opportunities, and due to this inadequate liquidity, because RBI had given some liquidity to the different persons to their bank accounts, but anyway RBI had given the more money, but it is yet not that sufficient to any person to fulfill the different needs, and yet it is inadequate liquidity. Most probably the RBI's action is laudable, but they are also inadequate. And one of the most telling stories, and the author compares with the test cricket match this economy situation. where once Pujara comes into picture, he is very stamina person and he defends the situation. And when the thing is going perfectly, that is when the bowlers are bowling into the perfect areas, then he tells that he compares the economy will recover like the one who comes into the picture, that is Rishabh Pant. So this is regarding the missed opportunity, and most of the opportunities, like how much the workforce which is in demand due to this lockdown, no matter what is MGNRA, which plans to give a work for every labor, but it is unable to provide a work facility for every person. Only 53% higher than the last year have been modest and also incurred and given this opportunity for the people who are under this MGNREGA, that is Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act. And this is regarding threats and weaknesses. What is that saying? That soaring assets, because of this inflation, there is a rise in prices. Due to this rise in prices, there is a tightening of interest rates by the RBI. And due to this tightening rates of RBI, there is a lack and lucrate of the one who is coming into the picture. The slowdown in the exports and also mislead of aversion in two way due to external trade. So due to this lockdown, there is a slowdown in export and also mislead of aversion in two way of external trade. This is what authors tells, is that ill-thought policies such as controversial farm laws also, which are weakened to the blueprint of budget in difficult times. So there is also non-negotiable things. How can we not neglect the very important thing, is that due to this COVID-19 exposed multiple lacunae in the India's public health infrastructure, which have to spend more on health sector. That is, in defense preparedness also essential due to this border threat. There are also private players not willing for the fresh investment due to the rise in the interest rates, and also public lifting must do a heavy lifting and pull of economy. So these are the ones which should not be neglected or non-negotiables. So due to this, there is a threat and weaknesses for the persons, and also the government has to spend more amount of money, so-called GDP, rather than expected. So these are additional burdens for the government. And due to this, there is a basic income safety of net, which is as well required. And situation is grim, and the author says that considering all these considerations, so-called the missed opportunities, non-negotiables, threats and weaknesses, the blueprint of the budget should be kept in mind for all these things. And let's look into the next article, which just says that in search of malice. So because of the abuse of law, the FIRs against some of the journalists and also the social media activists such as Shashi Tharoor was filed due to just the tweets which were viral, which says that the one who had been died when the tractor overturned during this protest, and this is due to the police has invoked the offense of sedition and conspiracy and promotion of the enmity between different sections. But the author says in this article, it just that should not be done in search of malice. They should be given some amount of malice, and this is incorrect account of abuse of law, which says in this article FIR should not be fined against the journalists. Now for next article, which says that White Azil, which gives an important article, which says that there should be a proper debate before amending any laws. We have seen regarding the new article, which is that new law, which is the farm laws, which has been not into the debate or not consulted with the opposition parties, but this was implemented, and due to this farm laws, the situation has been worsen, and due to this the economy or some of the things which are uncontrollable, we are seeing the farm laws, but they should be pushing through the parliament for debate in detail. So these kind of things to be done in the ordered plan, or so-called the government and opposition should talk, or headed by the coalition of course, in this due to pandemic situation and also budget session of the parliament, says the author of this article. The next article is regarding a champion of science and pro-food technology. This guy is regarding the 111th birth anniversary of Subramaniam Chandrasekhar, who was born, and he calls for the science for economic freedom of humanity. The author wants to say in this article, the food sufficiency goals. So the spirit of Subramaniam continues to live in a high moral ground, so there should be public and proper food sufficiency goals. The Ministry of Science and Technology bears a testimony and how he lived, and when India faced a reality of a ship to mouth status in 1960, when a few million tons of grains were imported, a superintendent goal of that India became self-sufficient in the food, and also 5 years to set its goal. So this is regarding the food sufficient goal. At 1960, the thought of Subramaniam continues to live in high moral ground. So the goal was realized, and the aid has been sustained since then. After that green revolution, the site used for storing the food grains, and also become the technology bone, which continues in the Ministry of Science and Technology, which serves as a reminder to the scientist, and also purpose of public investments in science must include the duty of the social and public good. The Agro Foundation, which was realized that the four E's of economy, environment, economy, education, empowerment, which is must and important for our farmers, the National Agro Foundation was gifted to this 98th birthday. So it was a journey of 21 years, and he had lived his ideals, and they institutionalized his well thorough farming centering programs. And to this world, they didn't leave themselves and also their immediate families. So this is what the Subramaniam had contributed to the science for the economic freedom of humanity, and which echoes his birth anniversary in the due course of time. Thank you. This is the end of the article discussion. Thank you for your time. Have a great day.